This is the RGM Mastermind GT22 controller, which controls a Fractal Audio XFX 2 in my rig. And I'd like to show you how I set it up. I made a similar video in 2015, and I got a little some requests to update that, because the Mastermind has been improved meanwhile, and the XFX has evolved meanwhile. But I haven't. Still hate making videos, but I like to make a demo of this. So this is my foreboard with wheels, made by Moonspinner Custom Gear here in the Netherlands. This is the RGM 22 buttons, and it gets its power by MIDI Phantom power from the rack. There are two expression pedals here, a little clock, and the AB switch for my different guitars by JHS pedals, and it gets its power from the RGM controller. Then there's a MIDI wireless by Shure, and this one gets its power from this battery, Big Joe battery, which is a fantastic thing, able to provide power to several pedals. Also on this floorboard is an iPad running Band Helper, an app, and it switches songs automatically whenever I choose another song on this RGM controller. This is the rack with a red panel, providing a lot of USB data and the power connections, and MIDI connections, inputs and outputs, and power. Here again is the XFX 2 XL version, soon to be replaced by an XFX 3. Everything going into a Behringer X32 producer, and then into these two Atomic CLR monitors. And here's a MacBook running X-Edit. So this RGM MIDI controller, it syncs automatically with the XFX. It gets all its preset information, the effects in a preset, and the bypass states of those effects, tuner and tempo, etc. And it adds to that full flexibility. What you see here is the layout I use with the kitchen sink preset, my main preset in the XFX. And here it is on screen. It's at 74%, which leaves still room for more stuff. And it's got everything in it which I normally would use. Providing automatic volume swells, wah, flanger, phaser, chorus sounds, vibrato sounds, rotary, tremolo, all kinds of drive signs, two amp blocks providing 4 amp tones, delay, reverb, and everything can go to a virtual cabinet or into a my Seema Duncan power amp and Port City cabinet. All these effects are configured for both X and Y estates, providing many sounds. And this is the layout on my controller that does it all. The middle two rows, the blue switches, correspond to the effects in the preset, providing every boost and overdrive tone I would normally use to make it possible for me to bump up the volume level for solos and leads, to switch between the X and Y states of delay, etc., etc. There it is. Then the bottom row enables me to switch between presets. Also enable me to switch between scenes by pressing and holding the same switch. And whenever I press this button, amps, I get the opportunity to switch between the two amp blocks and between the X and Y states of each amp block. So this bottom row is very flexible, allowing me to do it all. And there's numbers at the bottom row correspond with the scene numbers. The top left button, the preset button, pops up a menu of presets within the XFX. And I can use previews or next here to scroll through all those presets. And I got a lot of them. Also, I can use this press and hold page number function, where I can just hit a few numbers and then directly jump to that specific preset, And if I want to return to the previous presets, I press and hold this one and I'm back home again. Of course, the up and down buttons here correspond to banking up and down or going in presets or song up or down. There are more pages available, but I only use the first one for my for the stuff I do most. So if I want to jump to the song specific presets, I press this one, and there the list, the RGM generated list of songs appear, which correspond to presets. And let me choose this one, Beautiful Day by U2. Here you see, and this is different from the other layout I showed you, but here you see in the middle the purple buttons, which correspond to the different scenes within that song-specific presets. And these scenes and the names help me to get through these songs on a gig. We play a lot of songs, 70 or something. I got multiple bands, so I need those pointers to get me through the numbers. Also, as I said, whenever I choose a song here, let's do it again. Let's go to Bittersweet Symphony by The Verve. When I press that switch, the iPad app switches also, giving me leads on that song, like lyrics or whatever. Well, there's a lot more to say about this all. It took me a while to land on this as my preferred layout, but it works so good for me. I haven't changed it in a long time now. Okay, that was it. Thank you. Bye-bye.